Hey guys! Today we're gonna learn how to scatter your object by painting vertex maps and scatter objects differently in every possible way. We're going step by step in this process. After learning the basics, we are going to paint plants in real time wherever you like. So let's get started. First, select the plane and set its size as you want. Then go to its properties and increase its segments around 200 across length and width. More segments help to get better detail in painting strokes. Now we need to convert this plane into a mesh by clicking this icon to edit in object mode. Now we can edit its polygons. Go to the polygon mode and select the live selection tool to select polygons on the plane. You can change the radius of the live selection tool by an option on the right side. Now we're going to draw a sign called yin yang. Go to the top view by clicking the middle mouse button, then select the size of your selection. After selecting the right size, select the polygons with one click. Now we need to create a curve line from the middle by deselecting the polygons. For that, press Ctrl and drag. It deselects the polygon where you draw. By this way, create the whole design of what you want to create, or in this case the sign of yin yang. After you are done with the selection, we're ready to create a vertex map. Now press Shift plus C to search our vertex map. Type vertex weight map on the search bar, then click it. Set its value to 100% and press OK. Now you can see red and yellow maps on the plane. The yellow portion is selected polygons to scatter our objects. Red areas are not affected by our scattering. To test our scattering, we're taking rock to scatter over our design. I am using the Forester plugin for rock to test. You can use any object. After adding rock, we need to scale it down and make some changes in its properties. Go to the Forester rock, change its subdivisions and shape property. For this example, we are taking two rocks with different physical settings to look different. You can add as many rocks in your scene. After tweaking all settings, now we need to add our Octane scatter. Go to the Objects menu in Octane Renderer and select Octane Scatterer. Now put those two rocks under the scatterer. On settings, change its distribution vertex to surface. Then we need to add the surface to place the rock. Drag or select plane into the surface field. Always start with the lower count value, in this case 500 is good. Now you can see the point distribution on the surface. To see the rocks, we need to go render view for that. Quickly set up the lighting by adding Octane Daylight, tweak the lighting, and hit the render. You can see the rocks are scattered over the whole plane, not where we wanted. For that, we need to add a vertex map tag to the scatter settings. Select the vertex map and add it to the vertex field by dragging it. Now you can see rocks are around our vertex map. Take a look at your distribution and now increase the count. These rocks are in the same direction. We need to randomize the scale and rotation. To change scale, go to scale properties and add noise to it. Instantly you can see the changes. In the noise and change the noise pattern as you like. Now for the rotation, I use a random effector. Go to the MoGraph option on effectors, select random effector. Drag the random effector to the Octane Scatters effector field, carefully. You can see by default it's randomizing the position. We have to uncheck the position parameter in the random effector. Now check the rotation parameter. Randomize rock's rotation by 360 degrees and change another parameter by adjusting values as you like. We're good with 25 and 45 degrees. Again, go to the scatter setting and make some changes to get the perfect design. you can change the seed to get a variation. Or go down to the brightness and contrast settings to get it right. After happy with the results, now we are ready to paint. Go to the vertex tag on the plane. Now you have a paintbrush on your mouse cursor, select the proper size and paint as you like. It will scatter those rocks where you draw. For deselecting, press Ctrl and paint. You can refine the shape of your design to get more visible on the render. Now you can draw anything or remove things that you don't like. Or you can help me and subscribe to my channel. The basics are over, now we're going to add plants to make a small forest scene. First, hide those rocks. Go to the Forester plugin and select a tree. Then go to its property, change its size. We need small plants to get a large scale forest look. Then go tree library, select any of these plants. I select this one. Increase its quality by going to tree parameters and increase the viewport level equal to render level. Sometimes it's necessary, but it takes more computer juice. Drag tree under Octane scatter. You can see it takes time to load heavy geometry. You can always reduce the count, depends on your look. Due to the previous settings on the random effector, our design is not visible properly. For now, uncheck the rotation parameter on the effector. Now all trees are straight, and they are facing the same direction. On the render view, I change its setting to direct light to path tracing, which gives a more realistic look. Change tree shaders to Octane shaders by selecting those, and go to the material setting, select convert materials. Now let's do some simple shading. Go to the leaf shader, go to node editor, and find color correct. Plug main image node to the texture, from color correct, connect to the transmission. In the color correction node, you can change hue, saturation, and contrast. By altering these settings, change the color of the leaf. By adjusting gamma, you can make the leaf more or less translucent. For getting a fast render to look, I just turn off the path tracing for now. Now, we are ready to randomize the rotation of plants. Check the rotation parameter on the effector. And give them a realistic look by placing different angles. Make your angles small. If you want to scatter your object anywhere, double-click on the vertex weight tag and start painting. You can scatter any object into any surface which has editable polygons. You can write something on it. It is a very easy way to create paths in the forest while previewing on the render. Now you can scatter anything with the use of an Octane scatterer. Thank you for watching this video, please help me to grow this channel. If you have any problem, comment down below. Okay, stay safe, stay healthy, and be awesome.